بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم، وبعد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back to the Quranic journey. We are going through the Quran and we are on Surah Baqarah, alhamdulillah. The backdrop of our discussion so far has been the Bani Israel and the start of the journey with the Bani Israel, particularly as it relates to the story of Musa alayhi salam and the kind of difficulties that he had with the Bani Israel after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved the Bani Israel from Fir'aun. So we continue on the journey, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَإِذْ قُلْتُمْ يَا مُوسَى لَن نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حَتَّى نَرَى اللَّهَ جَهْرَةً فَأَخَذَتْكُمُ الصَّاعِقَةُ وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ. And they said, remember when you said, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressing these Bani Israel, يَا مُوسَى, O Musa, لَن نُؤْمِنَ, we will not believe, لَن نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ, we will not believe in you, this message that you've brought, حَتَّى نَرَى اللَّهَ جَهْرَةً, until we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we want to see him, like physically we see him. Okay, so despite all of the blessings that Bani Israel have been given here so far, Allah has saved them from the wrath of Fir'aun, you know, taken them out of all of that difficulty, given them evident blessings within themselves, like seeing them, you know, parting through this river that drowned Fir'aun. And then after that, you know, they took this golden calf as a, you know, and started to venerate it. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now giving us all of these blessings. And then after that, still they say that we want to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَخَذَتْكُمُ الصَّاعِقَةَ, and then a huge calamity, a storm, they took over you. Okay? وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ. Now the scholars have said this sa'iqa, this kind of storm, this kind of calamity that overtook them, actually killed them. Okay? Actually totally wiped them out. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as you will say in the next verse, he then raises them up. But the point is that look at the arrogance of the people. Okay, the arrogance of the Bani Israel, like, you know, despite all of these blessings, Allah is just telling them, just submit yourselves now. Look at the evident blessings that I'm continuously bestowing upon you. And they still reject. And they still want to ask further questions and, you know, be more persistent in their misguidance and disobedience. So Allah says, فَأَخَذَتْكُمُ الصَّاعِقَةَ, then this calamity befalls you. وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ, and you are watching. So the scholars say that some people, they are making this question, we want to see Allah, and Allah just takes them and kills them, right? Takes their lives, whilst others are watching, like this is happening in front of their eyes. Okay? ثُمَّ بَعْثْنَاكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَوْتِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Then we raised you. Then we brought you back up. Then we, you know, basically resurrected you. مِنْ بَعْدِ مَوْتِكُمْ, after you had passed away. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, so that now you realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, you know, trying to bless you and trying to give you, you know, all of these blessings so that you submit yourselves, so that you become submissive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that you submit to the word of Allah. Okay? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, so you are thankful for the blessings that Allah has bestowed upon you. And then, so in terms of the historical context, what's happened is that as Allah, as Musa alayhi salam takes the Bani Israel from the clasp of Fir'aun, they migrate to a place called Altia. And Altia is this kind of barren land, it's, you know, away from Egypt, okay, away from Fir'aun and the Pharaonic kind of kingdom. And now they're in this place called Altia, which is past, you know, this Bahar they've spoken about previously, past this river, they're past there, and now they are in this place called Altia. And it is here that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again blesses the Bani Israel. And how does he bless them, protects them? Remember, this is barren land, there's not many resources there, but Allah says, وَظَلَّلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْغَمَامَ وَأَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَنَّ وَالسَّلْوَى. وَظَلَّلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْغَمَامَ, and then we clouded upon you, okay, we placed clouds upon you. Okay, so Allah subhanahu protected them and protected them from the weather, protected them, and there was a cloud literally going with them. Okay, and that cloud provided them rain, provided them assistance whenever they needed. وَأَنْزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَنَّ وَالسَّلْوَى. Then the question is, well, what are we going to do for food? Then Allah literally sends down from the skies manna and salwa. And the scholars said manna is like a type of bread, like it's a type of barley bread, and salwa is a type of a bird, which has really beautiful, rich, pure meat. Okay, so this is like literally, food coming down from the heavens. Allah is blessing the Bani Israel, okay, and sending down this food, this provision for them. كُلُوا مِن طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Eat from the good of what we have given to you. Meaning, we are sending this down, eat from it. Eat from that which is pure, because this is pureness. This is purity coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So eat from what we have given you. وَمَا ظَلَمُونَا وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. And by these people, the behavior that they have, the attitude that they have, the way they speak, the way they, and their disobedience with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are not وَمَا ظَلَمُونَا. Allah is saying they're not oppressing us. We're not getting oppressed as a result of their actions. We are not doing that. But rather, وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. They are oppressing themselves. They are oppressing themselves. And that's an important point to remember. When a person sins, when a person, transgresses the bounds of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do you think that you're affecting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by that? You think that you're causing difficulty upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? In reality, كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. They're pressing themselves, because in the end of the day, you are going to die. You're going to stand in front of Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to question you, what did you do? And as a result of that, those moments of disobedience, that will cause ultimate difficulty and distress in the world to come. And that is dhulm. That is literally you doing dhulm to yourself. Okay, we ask Allah for safety and security. He then says, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا ادْخُلُوا هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةَ فَقُلُوا مِنْهَا حَيْثُ شِئْتُمْ رَغَدًا وَادْخُلُوا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا. So now, after this place of Aldiya, the Bani Israel then progressed forward to Bayt al-Maqdis, which is Jerusalem. Okay, and this is the inheritance of Ya'qub alayhi salam, which is their great, great, great forefather. Okay, and so they now enter into this great city. Now, this city is something which is a place which is blessed. Okay, it is a means of protection, a means of security for them now that they're in a city, and Allah opens the doors for them. All right, so He says that enter this city. وَكُلُوا مِنْ حَيْثُ شِئْتُمْ رَغَدًا. And eat freely from wherever you want to. Now, be comfortable now. I'm blessing you now with a permanent residence and abode. So eat freely. وَادْخُلُوا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا. And enter into the doors of the city in a state of prostration, meaning in a state of humility and humbleness as you approach this door, giving thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessings that you've been given. Okay. وَقُولُوا حِطَّةً. And say hitta. Hitta, hitta means to be relieved, to be our sins to be forgiven. Okay, نغفر لكم خطاياكم وسنزيد المحسنين. We will forgive for you your mistakes, and we will increase only those doers of good. Okay, the muhsinin. So Allah is saying here, now that I have given this blessing to you, now be thankful and submit yourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay. And say hitta, meaning say, relieve us, Ya Rabb, forgive us our sins, okay? Take us away from this, take us away from the burden of our sins, okay? فَبَدَّلَ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا قَوْلًا غَيْرَ الَّذِي قِيلَ لَهُمْ. But those who oppress themselves, those who do this oppression that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about, they change the word hitta. And what the scholars say, that they change the word hitta to habba. Hitta means, hitta, which is mentioned here, is to asking Allah to relieve oneself of the sins that they have done, all right, that they have committed. They change that word. They change that word, in a sense of mocking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they change it to habba. Habba means a grain, okay, wa sha'ira, and a kind of barley. So they change the word. So Allah is telling him to say a certain word, and they change that word, mocking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can you imagine that? After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them everything, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives them, saves them from Fir'aun, and then, all of the various different blessings, He gives them shelter, gives them shade, forgives them, gives them food, literally falling from the sky, then enters them into this city, and asks them just to be subservient, okay, and submissive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they change the word, mocking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فبدل الذين ظلموا قولا. So those who are transgressing, those who oppress themselves, they change the word غير الذي قيل لهم to other than that which was said to them. فأنزلنا على الذين ظلموا رجزا. Then we sent upon those who oppress, okay, those who do the dhulm, rizza, a punishment. Okay, and the scholars have said that this punishment was a plague, and a plague so severe that caused extreme, you know, illnesses and difficulties to these people. And after all of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now, you know, is exacting his punishment. Min as-sama, from the heavens. Bima kanu yafsukun, due to what they openly transgress. The way, due to this act of open transgression, openly now, you know, mocking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then their own affair is only an affair of punishment. Okay. Then Allah says, وَإِذِ اسْتَسْقَى مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ فَقُلْ نَضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْحَجَرَ. Now, okay, and another snapshot now into the history is that the Bani Israel, they're established, and they ask Musa alayhi salam, you know, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us water. We want, you know, springs of water. So Allah, so وَإِذِ اسْتَسْقَى مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ. So then, so his people, the qawm of Musa asked him, you know, to seek water, istisqa. Okay, so then we said, Allah says, اضرب بعصاك الحجر. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the Prophet Musa alayhi salam to get his stick and to hit it upon the rock. Okay, فانفجرت من خثنتا عشرة عينا. Then from the rock burst forward, فانفجر, burst forward 12 springs. قَدْ عَلِمَ كُلُّ أُنَاسٍ مَشْرَبَهُمْ. Every group of people, every tribe, knew their place of drink. Meaning, the 12, from this rock, 12 springs burst forward, representing the 12 tribes of the Bani Israel. How do we know the 12 tribes of Bani Israel? Because the sons of Ya'qub alayhi salam were 12 in number, and they were the start of the Bani Israel, the tribes. And so each tribe sees these 12 springs, and they know this is our spring. Okay, each tribe goes there. Okay, the blessings of Allah. Kulu washrabu min rizqillah. Okay, eat and drink from the provision of Allah. Wala ta'thaw fil ardi mufsidin. And do not act wickedly, be wicked in nature, and be of those who cause fasad upon the earth. Okay. This is what we understand now so far about the Bani Israel. So some reflective points to take. First and foremost, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this passage of the Quran is basically, you know, trying to advise the Bani Israel and to admonish the Bani Israel, you know, for their lack of, you know, gratitude. And what we take from this is, you know, we really, really need to be people of gratefulness. We must be grateful for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon us. Because, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of the blessings that we have, they are a test for us. Okay? Some of these tests, they may be a means. You know, what Allah wants from us is that those blessings that we have are a means of getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the greatest way that we can get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give thanks. Give thanks. And one of the other things that we learn from the Bani Israel here is they are not content. Like Allah gives them something, they're still not content. Allah gives them something, they're not content. As we'll see in the next verse next time, they are, you know, despite this food coming down from the earth, they are, no, we're getting bored of this now. We want some herbs and cucumbers and onions and all of these other blessings. Okay? So these things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about here. In addition to that, I think one of the other things that we can really take from this is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you openings and blessings and, you know, facilitation in your life, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want from us? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants for us to remember Him in the times of good. If we look at Surah Al-Nasr, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ. When the help of Allah and the victory came, وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسِ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا. And the people entering into Islam in droves. See, as far as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is concerned, that was his mission. He wanted people to enter into the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in droves. Okay? Look at the difficulty that he went through in Makkah. And then when it comes to the Fath Makkah, the opening of Makkah, the conquest of Makkah, he sees groups and groups of people entering into the religion of Allah. And that is the success as far as the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is concerned. So what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala advise him? Fasabbih bihamdi rabbika wastaghfir. So then glorify with praise your Lord. Okay? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has fulfilled your mission, has completed your task, now return back to Him earnestly. Now remember Him profusely. Now give thanks to Him. And so what we take from that is, whatever blessing that we have in life, whenever we are in a difficulty and Allah, you know, fixes it for us, whenever we have a problem and Allah fixes it for us, we have an exam, we pass the exam, whenever we have good that Allah gives to us, Allah wants us to give thanks to Him at that point. Allah wants us to become subservient to Him at that point, to remember Him, to glorify Him, to praise Him, you know, to extol Him. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. That's why He's saying here that, you know, you are now going to enter into the city. I'm now giving you a permanent abode. I'm now going to give you a fixed place where you can, you know, prosper and remain. كُلُوا مِنْ حَيْثُ شِئْتُمْ رَغَدًا. Eat from wherever you want. You know, you've got full provision here. But He says, وَدْخُلُوا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا وَقُولُوا حِطًا. Okay, that can enter into this place in place of prostration. Okay, be submissive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. Allah wants us to make the connection between the blessing and the bestower of the blessing. That is very important. What is the connection there? And many people fail, right, due to a lack of insight, the connection between the blessing and the bestower of blessings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the strength to see that connection. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to be thankful and allow us to, you know, change our states from states that are ungrateful to states that are grateful, and that we are submissive, that we are conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every waking state. جزاكم الله خير وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.